father is white and my mother is black. So growing up in a mixed household, my mom taught me to love my complexion and how my hair would kink and grow outward and turn into an afro. So from a young age, I was sort of aware of my blackness. When I would be with that side of my family, I would learn black history, I listened to black artists, MJ being my favorite, to Motown, to 90s hip hop rap, Beyonce. And I have an uncle that would send me and my sister like books about the real like slave narratives and sort of black empowerment. And if I had not had these influential teachings, this part of American history would be totally lost to me, this part of my own heritage. So very often our black history is sometimes overlooked in our teachings and history lessons. In history class, we learned that we're stolen from our homelands and that we're forced into slavery. Then we learn about the great leaders that fought for our freedom. Martin Luther King Jr. said that he had a dream that his children will live in a nation where they would not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. What we learn about the black experience the other 11 months of the year is often not relevant to what's happening today. A month dedicated to black history should be taken seriously so people can be educated on the past and the ongoing work being done now. We need Black History Month because in 2016, we're still seeing black people denied work and education for the way that their hair grows from their natural scalp. In this day, we see more people of color shot down in the streets. In 2015 and 16, me and other mixed race people are told we're too light or not black enough to identify with ourselves. We still have work to do regarding race in our society. Our black history lessons can teach more dimensional experiences instead of the single story, as Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie told us in her Danger of a Single Story. Black history is American history. And my hope is that through continued awareness and appreciation, this can be taken advantage through February through January, all year round. So that's what I have to say. Thank you.
One thing, and I don't believe I'm wrong, that nobody can make it out here alone. Alone, all alone, nobody, but nobody can make it out here alone. There are some millionaires with money they can't use. Their wives run around like banshees. Their children sing the blues. They've got expensive doctors to cure their hearts of stone, but nobody can make it out here alone. Alone, all alone, nobody. But nobody can make it out here alone. Now, if you listen closely, I'll tell you what I know. Storm clouds are gathering, the wind is gonna blow. The race of man is suffering, and I can hear the moan, because nobody but nobody can make it out here alone. Alone, all alone, nobody but nobody can make it out here alone. Or a Kendrick Lamar's performance for the Grammys, you will see that there is a movement starting. A movement that uplifts African Americans from the negative events that have been happening and urges us to unify. Relating back to the poem, the force of this movement is coming, and while we African Americans can go far on our own, we can go even farther with the support of others. Nobody can make it through the world alone. No movement can continue without support. So stay informed and show your support for other ethnicities. Thank you.
Okay, hi guys. So like what Ms. Holliday said, we have the middle school chorus here to sing for for us today in honor of Black History Month. And the song is called Up to the Mountain, and it's an adaptation of Martin Luther King's last speech, I've Been to the Mountaintop, which was given the day before he was assassinated in 1968. We thought it'd be a fun and quick way to spread awareness of this month and what it means. The course has been working on the song for a while and can't wait to sing it for you all. So here's the middle school chorus with featured soloist Ava Williams singing Up to the Mountain.
I can see.